Time now for News Talk for this half hour, and Candy Hump is joining us from Quadsimia and here to talk about mobile devices and specifically websites that are mobile friendly. Because back in April, Google made a change in the way the search engine works, basically. So they say that 60% of searches are done now from a mobile device. And a mobile device can be your cell phone, for example, but then also iPads and stuff like that, right? Or is that different?
Actually, that is different. Tablets are not included in this algorithm update.
Okay.
It is just mobile devices.
Mobile devices, so your smartphone, for example. So 60% of those searches are being done from your smartphone, and the way they're changing things up is that if you have a website that is already, that is mobile friendly, that's going to go to the top before, say, someone else's website that isn't.
That's correct.
So if you're a local business, this can hurt you if you are not, if your website is not mobile friendly.
Yes, it can.
Okay, so when you're developing a website, is it like basically two different websites, one for your desktop and one for the mobile device?
We really try not to do that. We go the route of what's called a responsive website design. So it responds based on the device that you're using it on. If you're using it on a mobile device, it will build itself so that it looks correctly on a mobile device. Your buttons are where they should be, your text is larger, there's enough space around the links so that you can click on them without accidentally clicking on something else. When it's a full width website, desktop view, everything is more normal sized, what you're used to seeing.
Okay, all right. So it does almost seem like it's two different websites,
yes.
And that's got to be a little bit complicated. In one sense, too, because you can put more stuff on the screen with a desktop, and obviously you're condensing everything down for a mobile device.
That's correct.
So what is the best way, if you're like a local business, for example, and you have limited means when it comes to money to put together a website, and you spent money on a website, and now you got to upgrade, I guess first, you always have to upgrade, don't you? No
yes,
matter what.
You do.
A website is constantly growing and changing and evolving, right?
Yes, and the Google algorithm in particular has more than 200 parameters that it takes into account. So you always want to be on top of that. You always want new content, fresh content. You always want to be aware of what your users are looking for.
Okay, so if someone comes to you, what is the first thing they need to know when they come to you guys, for example, when it comes to building a website?
We would put analytics on their website, and we would look at how their visitors are using the website currently to see what is the most common things that a visitor from a mobile device is going to on the current site. If we can find that everyone from a mobile device is looking for contact us, looking for directions, looking for phone numbers, that's the information we want to present first on your mobile view.
Okay, and then you guys actually do have a website that we can show you right now on your screen, and it's of a company that you guys redesigned their website. Mm-hmm. So you have the old website and the new website, is that
yes,
the deal?
Yes.
So in this instance, what did you do for them?
We did a lot of research to determine what visitors were looking for when they were getting there from a mobile device. We also looked to see what were the things that people were going to click on first. It's always going to be, can I get a phone number? Can I do a quick search because I don't have time to go through the menu? Or can I get directions? So when we reformatted the website, we wanted to make sure that those things were on the screen as soon as you get there.
Okay, and one of the things that I noticed too, and this is what I know that I do this all the time. I use Google as a phone book.
Mm-hmm.
So when I search for a place to get my hair cut, for example, I search the place I want to go to, and I don't go to their website, but I hit the telephone number. How does that person make sure? And I don't, maybe you want them to go to the website, but how do you make sure that telephone number is up there, front and center, even before you go to the website?
That's called the Google Local Pack. And that is a little bit different. You want to make sure that whoever is doing your marketing or your website development for you has enrolled you in what's called the Google Local Business Center.
Okay, and is that a good thing? Because I'm not going to their website.
It actually is.
Okay,
because you can track those calls to see if it's being successful for you.
Okay, a lot of great information. Thank you so much for coming on the program tonight. We have Candy Hump joining us from Quadsimia talking about your mobile device, your mobile website, making sure that your website is mobile ready. Let's take a look now at your forecast coming up.
From Central New York's most